for this program as given to me from the Lord is to build and prepare an elite team for his end time army, to battle not only in the spiritual, but also in the physical, utilizing warriors from all the nations. Every country has their own elite force to battle an enemy anytime, anywhere. So too, this elite group will be made of very special warriors, God's own. They will be tasked with going behind enemy lines and infiltrating and defeating many of the unseen and unheard of. And in this, the end times will be risen up to help in the battles to come, not only just in the spirit, but also as it was in the days of Noah.
Last week in Ultimate Spirit Warriors.
Because it felt like it was kind of like a anxious or worry.
Tag it up. You get it?
Yeah.
Cool. Tag it up. Next one.
I walked in there. Something changed.
Right?
And I'm just like, and again, your brother invited me to, he's like, you want to come over and join us? I'm like, we're just watching. I want you guys to keep that synergy going right now because it's awesome. I just want to see it. I'm smiling over in the corner.
I'm loving it. Yeah. I really am. See, I get something out of this every time too. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you learn new things every time.
Every time.
Yeah.
Like, even me.
Yeah.
It's great. All right, guys. Thank head you. On out.
Appreciate it.
Great you job.
Thank you.
Yep. I get into it.
Aiden and Isaiah.
Okay, guys, new challenge, clear the room, okay? Different environment. This one isn't a physical challenge, okay? This one's a spiritual challenge. It's gonna test you. You're gonna go into a darkened room. You're not gonna be able to see anything, but you're gonna hear something. And then you're gonna have to try and discern the spirit that is in, okay? How are you feeling at the moment?
Go to you first.
Feeling confident in myself and the Lord.
Amen.
That he can help me through this.
Right.
And that's pretty much it.
Amen.
I'm feeling pretty confident. Earlier, we all prayed together, and by myself, I prayed that he would clean my ear of flesh and that it would just be him in my head. So that way, I just think of him and nothing else. So he'd help me decipher the message.
Amen. All right. Are you ready to go? Okay. Who's going first? Okay. On my go. Okay. Ready, set, go. So like we were talking about, just calming everything down. It's gonna be different after the first three or four goes because your heart rate's going to be up, which means this starts working harder, which means this kicks in, yeah? Which means we have to quieten it down. We have to get our rhythm back to where we were, to where we're still, yeah? That's when we hear from the Lord. Otherwise, this starts ticking and it starts making noises, yeah? So, just keep in that prayerful state. Keep calm. Be still and know that you got this, yeah? Amen. Because you're a warrior. Mm-hmm. You're not a warrior. Yeah, there's a difference between worrying and being a warrior.
Go.
How'd you go?
I got it.
Amen?
Amen, yeah. It took me a second to get my breath and calm down and just focus on listening and hearing for, like, the tone, like, the voice, to see, like, to image him, but in the way of spirit, not, like, flesh. Like, I tried imagining him based on, like, his, like, if I was with him and just heard him, like, in the spirit, like, not, like, if you look at someone, you could, like, assume, mm-hmm. but in the spirit, you're able to, like, see exactly through, like, if God was looking at him. So, like, it, okay. he kind of showed me, like, how they were, like, from his perspective, what they would be looking like, and that kind of showed me what it was. So.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah. Keep that taste.
All right.
Come to the red light as soon as you can, and then stop.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I bind and cast out the spirit of anger.
Correct. Exit here.
Take it up. Now.
I got it correct.
Amen.
Yeah.
How was it though?
It was good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
A bit weird?
Yeah.
Being in the dark?
Yeah.
Hearing this weird voice come on.
it was like, it sounded weird because it's not a language that I'm familiar to.
Right. But you discerned it.
Yeah.
Well, you didn't. Yeah? Okay, so how do you feel about the way it works?
I think it works good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What, hearing from him or?
Yeah, because it's like, it's kind of like I heard like multiple things.
Right.
But when I heard that anger, I was like, anger's it.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah.
Come to red light.
In the name of Christ, I bind and press and cast out this spirit of pride.
Be correct.
Tag it. Bag it.
This one was a little shorter, so I had to kind of maybe come up with something a little quicker. I didn't get it, but you're not going to get every single one on the first try. So you got to learn, like, if you're going to mess up, not be discouraged and go in with full confidence again. So that's what I'm going to do next time.
Yep. How are you feeling about the actual experience, though? Going into the dark room and...
It's making me have to rely on him and not so much of, like, when you're talking to someone, you kind of base your, like, feelings and what you're going to say off of what they look like and their feelings. And this, you just have to rely on the spirits a lot more. And it's something that I should be practicing more.
Yep.
And it's something that as I've been noticing I needed. So this is a good experience.
Amen. Something we should all be practicing more. Amen. Because we all need to practice.
So it's like, I heard multiple things this time.
Right.
Yeah.
So you had to decipher multiple things.
Yeah, so it was...
Were some of those things you?
I don't know.
Thoughts?
Yeah.
Inner voices and stuff like that?
Yeah.
So we need to really concentrate on his...
Yeah, because like the hard thing about it is like, when God speaks to me, it's like through my voice.
Yes. Yeah.
So I'm not sure if it's really
it's
me.
It's really hard, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm so envious and wish I had what people around me have. I'm so resentful as what makes them so special that they can have everything their hearts desire. And I'm left discontented with what God has given me. It makes me feel insecure about myself, and I'm sure if I had what they had, I would feel more fulfilled.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I bind and cast out the spirit of jealousy.
Correct.
Bag it up. I said to you guys, you're going to be all right the first one, and then the more times you go around and around and around, more this kicks in.
Yeah.
So we have to still it all down, bring it all back to our first love, and bring it all back down to stillness. It says be still and know, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
It says it for a reason. And we just have to take that on board every time.
See, like, went in there and tried using my head this time, and definitely did not help at all.
Yeah.
We are back. It is time to
embrace the uncomfortable.
The experience. Now we can see how truly hard it really is, yeah? And that's what it's all about. It's all a learning experience. We go to training for a reason, yeah? We go to training to work out the bugs. We go to training to watch the tape. we go to training to fix the mistakes from last week. That's all this is. It's all just looking at it from the outside in and from a different perspective, yeah?
In the name of Jesus Christ, bind the castle of spirit and grief.
Thank you.
Go.
Again, didn't get it right, but still not discouraged.
Yep.
Because I'm not going to get every one, but, you know, it was incorrect, so I just had to go with my second best, you know. That wasn't it, so I'm kind of curious what that one was, so I know which one that is. So
what'd you say?
I said greed, because the first time I said pride, and it sounded like pride again, but first time I said that, it wasn't, but, you know.
Okay, something I've been also sharing with the guys and girls is many of the spirits have the same traits, right? So if we go off one line of trait, 100 spirits could have that line, yeah? It's just getting the proper line matched up with the proper spirit.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I bind and cast out the spirit of death. Be good.
Go.
The more I feel like, the more I run around, the harder it gets.
Exactly, right? And that's why we do it this way. Because we keep your heart rate up. You start to get a bit anxious. You're getting tired. You start to think more, yeah? It all comes back to bringing everything right back down to where we should be, yeah? And learning how to get it back down there. That's really important, yeah? We need to multitask. We need to bring everything all the way back down, not to simplicity, but back down to that quiet stillness where all we can hear is God's voice.
Yeah.
And then We've got it.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I finally cast out the spirit of disbelief.
Incorrect.
It's just training, man. It's training. That's all it is.
Didn't get it this time again, but you know, so gotta go in there and go again. Can't keep thinking about the times you get wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta, because you're not like I said, you're not gonna get everyone right. And the more you get wrong, the more you're gonna have to rely on them and less on yourself, because you're gonna realize the more you try on your own, the more you're gonna get wrong. So,
yeah. And it's practice. You're not gonna get it right the first time in 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Who would? Otherwise, we'd all be surgeons and all be, you know what I mean? Yeah. You can't fly a plane if you don't know how to fly a plane. It is what it is. We all go to training, we all practice. That's all this is, yeah?
Incorrect.
Yeah. Which got one, so, huh?
Yeah.
We're learning. This is what it is.
Yeah, in general, I only wanted to get one.
At least you get one.
Yeah. If I got one, I'm still proud of myself.
Exactly.
And I'm proud of God, too.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
Because we need more of Him in us.
Because
what did the cross challenge teach us?
That it's more of just like, okay, you. Like, it's not just you by yourself. You need teamwork. You need God's help.
Mm-hmm.
Like, doesn't matter who you are, you need help, no matter what.
And He's on your side for a reason.
God's on our side, no matter what.
Yeah, and He's got our back.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Said, like I thought I could tell by the voice, and then again started using my head, and then that thing that just messed me up again. There's always like my head always just seems to try to find a way to get in, so it's very difficult to try shutting out the flesh in your head.
Yeah. You know what?
Yeah,
but at least now you know what you need to focus on more.
Yeah,
yeah, and what you need to really dial in. Yeah. We need to dial that God channel in, you know?
Yeah.
And that's the important point of this too. We need to be hearing from Him and be shutting ourselves out. That's it. Through this experience, okay? We've got some, we haven't got some. It's cool, either way. It's all about learning, it's all about the training. What are your overall views on the experience?
Overall view of the experience is probably the learn to just hear from him and try to block out distractions, and not only just external distractions, but like internal distractions, mm-hmm. like my own mind, like my own voice in my head. To try blocking that out so I can hear him. You know, it's very difficult, but I feel like it's something if I keep practicing, I could get.
Amen. Yeah?
Yeah.
Amen. Important. Very important.
We need God to help us discern things that we can't discern ourselves, because the stuff that we had to do in there, that was something that we could only know by supernatural.
Exactly.
And, yeah.
We got to get our supernatural on, you know?
Yeah.
Amen. All right, boys. Well done. Head out. I'll catch you guys later, all right? We'll be back after this.
We are back. It is time to
embrace the uncomfortable.
Team Elisha, Ethan and Michaela.
Gonna head in. It's gonna be dark. We have to discern, bind, and cast out. Okay? Gonna come back down, tag your partner, partner goes. Okay? You good to go? How are we feeling?
Yeah. Excited.
Fair enough. Good to know. Fair enough, good to know. You ready to go? Alright, on my go. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Tag it up, come on, let's go, tag it up. Never played tag before. What do we need to pray for?
Better discernment.
Fair enough, how was it in there?
It was weird. The voice sounded really weird and just like, never heard that language before.
Mm, yeah, so, it's one of those languages that's not, you can't really pick anything out of it. And it all sounds it doesn't sound like it's supposed to, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. So how did you go? Did you pick it? Did you get it?
Mm-mm.
No?
No.
Okay. Did you guess?
Not really.
Okay, cool. That's good. Doesn't matter if you don't get it, as long as you don't guess, yeah? As long as you don't let this get in the way. You start thinking about it, what happens? You don't hear from him. It's not him talking. It's this talking. And that's where we all go wrong. We don't actually stop and listen for him to then give us the discernment, to then bind and cast out. This kicks in, and then we go, what does it sound like? Can I get any vocal cues out of it?
Here he comes. I heard the run. Yo.
Get out of here.
It was not what I was expecting.
Alright. Good.
Yeah, that's it. It was just...
Did you get it right?
Oh, no.
Thank you.
jealousy?
Sadness, jealousy, pride. Unforgiving.
I don't think you have enough fingers. But
yeah, but no. I'm still, like, I'm thinking, like, they're not gonna go ahead and put hard ones up there.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, you've gone through the challenge now. How did you go, and what did you get out of it?
I think I guessed too much and didn't rely on like the Holy Spirit to like give me like wisdom and like discernment over like what the Spirit was. But yeah, I got a few of them right, but I think I guessed on those too.
Okay. You got a feeling of what it's like.
Yeah.
Yeah? Amen.
Same. I started to pray toward the end. I didn't really pray beforehand because, I don't know, I felt like I didn't have the power of discernment.
Okay.
I felt like I didn't have the power of discernment.
Right.
And so, until this show, never really thought about discernment. So
yeah.
It's like, how can you have it if you've never even heard of it? But yeah, I just guessed a lot, and toward the end I started praying, and I think maybe one out of the five were answered.
Right.
I definitely relied a lot on Kayla here. I thought she was just gonna get all right. I was just kind of banking off of her. So yeah.
But you got a taste.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right. Great job. Head on out.
Get some sleep.
For more details, you may contact USW Show, Unit 510 Millwood Avenue, Narellan, New South Wales 2567, Australia. Or you may send an email to uswshow@gmail.com. And you may also follow us on our various social media platforms.